Hello everyone, welcome to the online practical sessions. Today we will be looking into experiment 2 of second PUC, which is resistivity of the material of the wire. So our aim today would be determination of resistance of a given wire using meter bridge, and hence to find the resistivity of the material of the wire. Here the ultimate aim would be to find the resistivity. And we will have to understand the term resistivity of the material of the wire. So, resistivity is the property of the material. We will recall some theory part related to resistivity. So, have a cylindrical wire whose length is L and the area of cross section is A. Then the resistance of the wire is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area. If you take out the proportionality, we will get a constant, and resistance is going to be equal to the constant resistivity into the length divided by area. Today we are supposed to find resistivity. Let us rearrange the formula. On rearranging the formula for resistance, we will get resistivity as resistivity is equal to area of the wire into the resistance of the wire divided by the length of the wire. This is the formula for resistivity of the wire. So today we are given a wire. This wire is made of nichrome. So I have to find out the resistivity of the material, which is the resistivity of the material nichrome. If I have to find the resistivity, then I should be knowing the resistance of the wire, the area of cross section of the wire, and the length of the wire. Finding the length is very much easier. If I have a scale or a meter scale, I can measure the length. To find area of cross section, I will be using a screw gauge. If I have a screw gauge, I can find the diameter of the wire, and from diameter I can calculate the area of cross section of the wire. Well, I may not be in need of the screw gauge always. The wire that I am using, I have purchased from a laboratory supplier. He has provided me the data regarding the wire. Here if you see, it has been mentioned as nichrome wire, and the statistics also tells the wire is of standard wire gauge number 26. It's been written here SWG, which means standard wire gauge, and it is numbered 26. If I have a clutch table and if I open the page where it's been mentioned as electrical and magnetic data, so here they have given what is the diameter of nichrome wire for standard wire gauge 26. So the diameter is mentioned there. For standard wire gauge 26, the diameter is, just a minute, come towards this side. Yes, here it is, 0.4572. Here it's been mentioned diameter in mm. So for standard wire gauge 26, the diameter is 0.4572 mm. So by having the data from the Clark's table book, I can directly calculate the area of cross section of the wire. Finally, I am left with finding the resistance of the wire. How do I find the resistance? The resistance of the wire is found out using a meter bridge. We have learnt in our theory part that a meter bridge works on the principle of Wheatstone's network. We'll recall in session 12 of chapter 3, current electricity, we have studied about the meter bridge, the principle of working of a meter bridge, or the balancing condition for a meter bridge. So today the main experiment to perform would be to find the resistance of the given wire using a meter bridge. From finding the resistance of the given wire using a meter bridge, later we will be calculating the resistivity of the material of the wire. So let us look into the principle of this experiment now. Let us recall the principle of working of the Wheatstone's bridge. If P, Q, R and S are the four resistors in the different arms of the Wheatstone's bridge, then First thing, the Wheatstone bridge is balanced when the current through the galvanometer is zero. So the current in the galvanometer will have to become zero. And when will it become zero? When the condition P by Q is equal to R by S is being satisfied. We will understand this principle better when we perform the experiment today. So let us start performing the experiment. Now let us look into the circuit diagram to perform today's experiment. Here all the lines or the diagrams written in white color represent the apparatus, and the lines drawn in blue represent the wire connections that we need to make later. Here in this diagram, the L-shaped box here, the rectangular box here, and the another L-shaped box onto the left with this orange color wire. This represents the meter bridge or a Wheatstone's network. So this is the meter bridge which works on the Wheatstone's network. This represents the point A, and this is the first L-shaped box which has been written in the circuit diagram. This represents the point B, and this is the middle rectangular portion which was been drawn in the circuit, and this is point C, and this L-shaped conductor represents the L-shaped diagram drawn on the circuit, and here you see the wire. So that's the meter bridge wire. The same apparatus is been drawn in the circuit diagram. We'll proceed. Now in this meter bridge we have a right gap. In the right gap we connect the resistance wire for which we are supposed to find the resistance. In the Wheatstone's network the same is been mentioned here as R. This is left gap. If you make your left and right, so this is the left gap from my point of view, and in the left gap a standard resistance box is being connected, and this S is was what is being represent here in the Wheatstone's network. Next we have P and Q. In the meter bridge a wire runs from A to C, and this wire from A to C acts both as P as well as Q. How can be known later. Finally a galvanometer is connected to B, and the galvanometer is next connected to a jockey. So here we have a galvanometer and a sliding contact, or the other name being jockey. This arrow mark here represents the jockey, and the S, which is standard resistance box, is been represented here. So this is a standard resistance box. Other than this, we have also connected the point A to a battery. So this battery supplies the necessary power required for the working of the Wheatstone's network or for the working of the meter bridge. So I have a battery here, or I can also call it as an IC regulated power supply. It's been mentioned here as IC regulated power supply. And here is a tap key. I'll be using a tap key where when I tap the circuit would get closed and the meter bridge starts working, and when I release the circuit is open and the meter bridge stops working. So this is a tap key. From now on we'll start conducting the experiment. So before I start conducting, one more thing. The principle tells the Wheatstone bridge is balanced when P by Q is equal to R by S. I am supposed to find the resistance R. Let me rearrange. R by S is equal to P by Q. I want to find R. Here this part of the wire from A, if I mention here as D, from A to D is the wire which acts as P. We know that the resistance of the wire is directly proportional to its length. So instead of P, I can write L, and then the part DC or this part of the wire acts as Q. What we have is a wire of 100 centimeters length. So if this part is 100 and the remaining is 100 minus L centimeters, and Q is directly proportional to its length. So instead of Q, I can write 100 minus L, rearrange. So R will be equal to S into L divided by 100 minus L. This formula will help us today to perform the experiment. I will be finding the resistance of the given wire by knowing what is L, which is the resistance in a standard resistance box, by knowing the length L, which is the balancing length, and the remaining length 100 minus L. If I know these parameters, I can find the resistance of the wire. Let us start conducting the experiment. So before I start conducting the experiment, I have to do the circuit connections. Whenever we have an electrical circuit to be connected and an experiment to be performed, the first thing, the proper way of performing the experiment is to arrange the apparatus as given in a circuit diagram. That helps us in doing proper connections. So I have arranged the apparatus almost similar to the circuit diagram. If you see here, on the right gap, the experimental wire is been connected and I have placed on the right gap. In between, a galvanometer is needed to be connected, so I have placed a galvanometer. On left gap, a resistance box is to be connected, so I have placed a resistance box. This AC is nothing but the wire of the meter bridge, for which I need not do any connections. Below the meter bridge, a battery is being kept, so I have placed a battery. If I place it ahead, you may not see the readings, so I have placed it here. And finally, a tap key. So I have placed a tap key. Now we'll start connecting either in anti-clockwise or clockwise. Let me begin clockwise. The first thing, on the right hand side, on the right gap, the experimental wire is being connected. So first I will connect the resistance wire. So I have connected the experimental wire. Next, from middle to the galvanometer. So I am going to connect one end of the galvanometer to the point B. Next, the galvanometer is connected to a jockey. This arrow mark or a tail like thing is nothing but a jockey. Have a jockey. For the sake of performing the experiment, I will take a lengthier wire. So I will connect the jockey to another end of the galvanometer. So this finishes this connection. Next, left hand gap. A standard resistance box is being connected. Let me make these connections. So this is the left hand gap. Connect to the two ends of the resistance box, one end and the other end. This finishes the connection of resistance box. Next, come here. The point C is connected to a tap key, one end of the tap key. I will be connecting the point C to one end of the tap key. Next, the another end of the tap key is connected to battery negative. I'll be taking another wire. Connect the another end of the tap key to battery negative. If I connect from above, there will be some obstructions, so I will be connecting from below. Here I have connected the other end of tap key to the battery negative. Finally, the battery positive is connected to point A. So the battery positive is connected to point. These both are interconnected. You can connect at either place. So this finishes the proper way of connecting any of the electrical circuits. Always remember, whenever you are performing an electrical experiment or an electronics experiment, the proper method would be to arrange the apparatus as given in the circuit diagram and then connect either in clockwise or in anti-clockwise. While connecting, trace every connection that you have done, which will make sure that you have connected all the wires and nothing is left untouched. Now let us look into the circuit once more. We'll recall once again, from my point of observation, at the right gap I have connected an experimental wire. And one more thing, when you are connecting the experimental wire, we are using the length of the wire in the calculation at the end. Therefore, many of them make the mistake while connecting, they wind at this terminal. That's wrong. You can't wind, but you have to only connect the edges. So connect the edges of the wire. Do not wind. Winding eliminates some length of the wire from the actual experiment. So do not wind. Next, the middle part is connected to the galvanometer. The point B is connected to one end of the galvanometer. The another end of the galvanometer is connected to the jockey. Make sure you have sufficient length so that you can slide from one end to another end without any obstruction. Next, onto the left gap, I have connected the standard resistance box. So one end of the left gap to one end of the resistance box, another end of the left gap to another end of the resistance box. Next, the point C is connected to a tap key. The another end of the tap key goes to battery negative. This goes to battery negative. A battery has a positive terminal which is red and a negative terminal which is black. The tap key is connected to the negative terminal. Next, from the positive terminal, we are going to connect to the point A. These two points are interconnected. Don't get confused. You can either take the terminal here or the above terminal as point A. They are interconnected. They are the same. Now we'll start performing the experiment. So while performing the experiment, I have to note down these observations. The first one being the radius of the wire, and generally it will be given. The data is given, or you can get it from your collapse table. We'll come to this at the end. And then length of the wire, even this can be noted later. This tabular column is what is related to the meter bridge. So we'll understand here what is this tabular column. First, we'll unplug some resistance from the standard resistance box and then find out the balancing length L. Find out the balancing length L. Note down. From L, you can find out what is 100 minus L. And finally, calculate the resistance of the given wire using the formula R is equal to S into L divided by 100 minus L. The first trial, let us perform by unplugging 2 ohms in the resistance box. Let us begin. Before you begin, make sure all the plug keys are tight enough, or else you may not get proper readings. So just press them tight enough, press and twist a bit. that will make sure that the keys are tight enough. For the first trial, I will unplug 2 ohms. It's been written here 1, 2, 2, 5. I'll unplug 1, 2 ohm. Now, a 2 ohm resistance is connected in the left gap. So, this makes 2 ohm resistance connected in the left gap. Let me start performing the experiment. Switch on the battery supply and set it nearly to 2 volts. It's already been set. After switching on, tap the key and verify whether you get deflections in the galvanometer. I'll place the jockey on two ends, that is on end A. Now I'm getting a deflection onto my right. Now similarly, tap the key and place it on the end D and see, you get deflection onto the other side. Observe once more. Let me repeat once more. Tap the key, place the jockey onto the right. You are getting a deflection. Now place the same key onto your left. Again, you are getting a deflection. And the deflections has to be on both right hand side and left hand side. After checking for opposite deflections, now I can find the balancing length. Now let me start finding the balancing length. Take the jockey to the right hand edge, press the tap key and then find out the balancing length. The balancing length is the length when you get the galvanometer deflection as zero, which is also called as null deflection. Now look at the scale reading. It is showing nearly 56.4 centimeters. So we'll note down this in the tabular column. So this will give me 56.4 centimeter and 100 minus L is going to be 43.6 centimeters. To note down R, let me make the calculations. Trial 1, R is equal to S is 2 into 56.4 divided by 43.6. 2 into 56.4 gives me 112.8 divided by 43.6, and this will further give me the answer as nearly 2.59 ohms. I'll round off the answers to 2 decimals. So I'll note down this. It is 2.59 ohms. The second trial I'll perform for 4 ohms. I'll be unplugging 4 ohms in the resistance box. So let me begin. If you observe in the resistance box, there is no number 4 been written, but you have 2 and 2. So by unplugging 2 and 2, we are introducing 4 ohms in the left gap. So let us begin. Tap the key always and then perform the experiment. So come into your right hand and find the balancing length. The balancing length is for zero deflection. Now I have got zero deflection. Let us look into the meter scale reading. So the meter scale reading is showing nearly 42 centimeters. Let me note down this. The balancing length is 42 centimeters. Let me note down it as 42.0. So 100 minus L will give me 58.0 centimeters. To find R, let me make the calculations. Trial number 2. R is equal to 4 into 42.0 divided by 58.0. 4 into 42 will give me 168 divided by 58.0, I'll get the answer as 2.90 ohms. So let me note down 2.90 ohms. Next, the final trial we'll be performing for 6 ohms. Let me unplug 6 ohms in the resistance box. Now look at the resistance box. You don't have number 6 here. What you have are 1, 2, 2, 5 and then it goes to 10. So to make 6 ohms, I'll be unplugging 5 and 1. 5 and 1 together will make 6 ohms. So now I have connected a resistance of 6 ohms in the left gap. Press the tab key and then slide the jaw key from your right unless you get zero deflection. So if you look at here, I have got zero deflection and the reading in the scale is nearly 32.4 centimeters. So let me note down this. I'll note down the reading here. The balancing length is 32.4 centimeter. 100 minus L will give me 67.6 centimeter. And to find R, let me make the calculations. R is equal to 6 into 32.4 divided by 67.6. The numerator, I'll get the value as 194.4. So divide this by 67.6. The answer is going to be 2.88 ohms. So let me note down this. So these are the values that I have got. I will actually have to get constant value or the same values, but when you come to your laboratory, you will find that the resistance boxes are not accurate. There are small variations with the resistance. Though it may have been mentioned as 1 ohm or 2 ohm, it may not be exactly the same. So small errors are included in the experiments. Therefore, we will get small variations. Let me find the mean of these three. The mean value of the resistance or the average value of resistance is going to be equal to 2.59 plus 2.90 plus 2.88. Divide this by number of trials, which is 3. So I'll get the answer here as 2.79 ohms. Let me note down this. Mean R is 2.79 ohms. I have found out R. So the major part of the experimenting for today is over. Now we are left with calculations for resistivity. For calculating resistivity, I have to find out finally the resistance of the wire and the length of the wire. Before I start doing the calculations for resistivity, let me clarify one more thing here. The calculation for resistance, where I made use of a formula, has to be written in your examinations as well as in your record books. Calculations carry marks. So the calculations which I had written earlier has to be written even in your practical record books. Even there, we have to mention all the calculations that we have done. Now, let me note down the resistance and length of the wire. As mentioned earlier, generally you will get the radius or diameter through your Clark's table or through the data sheet. We had seen there the diameter was been mentioned as 0.457 mm, which is millimeter. So half of this will give us radius. So if I divide this by 2, radius is half of diameter. I'll get the value as 0.2285 millimeter. I'll round it off to 0.23 millimeter. So the radius is going to be 0.23 millimeter. SI unit is meter. So the milli, I'll convert it into powers. I will get this as 0.23 into 10 to power of minus 3 meter. I have got the radius. Next, I'm supposed to find the length. How will I find the length? To find the length of the wire, remove the wire from the connections. Place it on the meter bridge where you have a scale to measure. So measure it. I'm getting the value nearly as 38 centimeters. You look here, it is nearly 38 centimeters. Of course, you may not get the length exactly because of the twisting of the wire, the bends and curves in the wire, but still the approximation is enough. So I'll note down the length as 38 centimeters. The length of the wire is 38 centimeter. Again, SI unit is meter and not centimeter. So the term centi in powers can be written as 38 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meters. 38.0 into 10 to the power minus 2 meters. I have got the radius, I have got the length. Let me calculate the resistivity. Before I start calculating resistivity, I need to find the area of cross section. I have the formula to find the area. So pi is 3.14, radius is 0.23 into 10 to power minus 3 whole square. On calculating, I will get the answer as 0.166 into 10 to power of minus 6 meter square area. So the SI unit for area is meter square. So let me note down here, this is 0.166 into 10 to power of minus 6 meter square. I have the area. Now I can calculate the resistivity. Therefore, resistivity is going to be equal to resistance of the wire, which is 2.79 ohms. The area 0.166 into 10 to power minus 6 meter square whole divided by the length, which is 38.0 into 10 to power of minus 2 meters. So let me do the calculations. In the numerator, I'll get 0.4634 into 10 to power of minus 6 whole divided by 38.0 into 10 to power of minus 2. So this will give me 0.01219 into 10 to the power of minus 6, and the minus 2 in the denominator when it goes to numerator. So minus 2 in the denominator, when it goes to the numerator, it becomes plus 2. Minus 6 plus 2, I can directly note down it as minus 4. Finally, I'll round off the answer in terms of minus 6 itself. The standard values of resistivity of the wires is generally in micro ohm meter. So if I shift the decimals to have minus 6, then shift it 2 places, 1, 2, I'll get the value nearly as 1.22 into 10 to power of minus 6 ohm meter. Finally, we have completed the experiment. The last thing remaining is to note down the result. When you look into the data sheet related to nichrome wire, you find the resistivity of nichrome wire nearly to 1.1 micro ohm or so. Well, while performing experiments in the laboratory, there are errors related to the apparatus that we are been using. So small variations from the actual value is acceptable, provided the experiment that you have performed is been verified by the lecturer who is been present there. If the values that you have noted down is been verified by the lecturer who is present there, then these values are acceptable. Well, the small error can be rectified later. The experiment is concluded by noting down the final result. Let me note down the result at the end. Finally, the result is been noted down. the resistivity of the material of the wire is equal to 1.22 into 10 to the power of minus 6 ohm meter. Many a times we are performing resistance per unit length as our first experiment, where the SI unit is ohm per meter, but resistivity is ohm meter. We generally encounter many times that students note down the SI unit for resistivity as ohm per meter, which is a wrong practice. So be conscious while you are noting down the unit for resistivity. Resistivity is ohm meter. And a question arises: will the resistivity change when the length of the wire changes, or will the resistivity change when the area of cross section of the wire changes? The answer is no. Resistivity is the property of the material of the wire, and it is independent of the length and area of cross section of the wire. Finally, in your practical exams, marks are being provided even to write the result with proper SI units. So make sure the SI unit what you mention at the end is right, and you write proper result with proper statements. That's all for this session.